for ankle dorsiflexion. So you're going to set up so that there's just a little bit of a stretch, the basement of this movement. Now, you're going to do a little pales contraction, which means you're just going to press the forefoot into the ground so that you could just slide a piece of paper under your heel. This is the pales contraction. You are then, after 10 seconds, going to do a rails contraction, which means you're going to pull your heels to the ground, pull your toes to your shin, pull the top of your foot to your shin. This is a strong dorsiflexion, at least 80% of your max effort, and then release. You should be able to then inch backwards a little more. Same thing, pales contraction, just pressing the forefoot into the ground, tiny bit, so a piece of paper can slide under your heels, 10 seconds. And then a rails contraction. Pulling the heels to the floor, driving them in. You're almost trying to lift the forefoot off of the scale, 10 seconds. Beautiful. Now, you can also do this with the knees bent. So, same thing. Try to find that basement of the movement, and then pales contraction, push the forefoot in. So you're just lifting up a tiny bit. Then, after 10 seconds, reaching the heels to the floor and using everything on the front of your shin to pull, pull, pull. So you do 2-3 sets of each of those. You can also take the other foot away, so you're doubling the load through here, but this is that nice forward pressure that we want for ankle hinge.